right, cool. We are live out here in Towson, Maryland. My name is Shadid Drake. For we got UVA versus Towson. We kind of missed a little bit of the first one. Our apologies. Woo! UVA got less than 10. Jake can't really throw today. Vicious. That was a vicious shot. You love to see it. Three play left. Jake's still alive. Three players left for UVA. More than six for Towson. Team throw miss. Oh, that's a good catch by Strong, number 37. One play left and Jake. They look like they're going to do a team throw against him. Nope, never mind. Two players left in UVA. My apologies. Yeah, two players left. Team throw. Does not get him. He's still alive. UVA have three balls exactly on the court. All right, cool. He just threw his ball. UVA does not have a shot clock. Oof. Jake just got hit on the team throw. One play left to beat. He's still alive. All Towson got to do, get a team throw in this situation, they'll be up 1-0. Oh, that's a hit. Woo! Good pump fake. Really good pump fake. Got him. 34 ball with the kill. Towson's up 1-0. We're still trying to get the clock here on the court. We do not know how many assignments left. The Maryland refs, they know how many assignments left.
I picked Oklahoma State to cover at least. But that's all you were talking about.
Wait, are you gonna check too?
Yeah.
I listened to the pod.
Hard infiltration, 1, 2, 3.
I listened to the pod. I was listening to the pod.
Alrighty. So UVA goes down. Multiple pump fakes does not work. Uh-oh. Number one.
Hey, right side, left side.
Go for the team. Nope, never mind. No team throw. It's a good reset throw, nevertheless. Keep them honest. Hunter. Oh, did he step out? He did. Got double zero out. Good shot. Good shot right there by UVA, trying to get his number. Taking out number 33, Bass. What a shot. They're quick on the trigger.
Oh,
another kill for UVA. Oh, he's aggressive. My goodness. Woo. All right, it's getting crazy now. Oh, what a shot. Pretty sure that's number 24 UVA trying to get his name. We'll try to get the names during the halftime, and my goodness, Hunter, the throw does not get it, but the good reset, though, keep his team honest. Keep UVA minds in this situation. Lots of long throws, but they are connecting. UVA is looking pretty good at this point. Another reset throw. Multiple pump fakes. Towson will be able to get that orange ball. And just like that, UVA only got two balls left. Because they have less than three, the shot clock is not a factor right now. Hunter, the throw does not get it, but strong throw nevertheless. Keep his opponents very honest. Team throw, let's see if it's gonna be on the left or on the right. They're talking about it. Team throw, not quite. Whoa, the stagger team throw. The stagger team throw, a deadly weapon used very effectively to create distortion and confusion. You love to see it. Not a bad throw. Oh, what a catch! What a catch by UVA! Once again, he is making big plays. We're trying to get his number. He just need to turn around so I can see it for the one time. Number 60, I'm pretty sure that's my man Kelly. Pretty sure it is. We'll confirm real soon. Woo! UVA, very athletic. One of their best teams, if not their best team thus far in their history. Making a strong push to try to get this point against Towson. Brown. All right, UVA got four balls. Towson got the rest of the six. Slight man advantage in favor of UVA. Number 10, he said he got it. Not a bad reset throw. Very conservative from both teams right now. High throw, reset. Towson trying to pin their opponent to the back line. Hunter. Now they're about to get ready for the team throw. It seems like it's going to be on the right side. And they got two. They got one of them out of that exchange. Number 10 goes down. Good job on number 6 of UVA stopping that ball. Not bad. Not bad. Good block. My goodness. Oh, what a toe tapper! What a toe tapper! Intelligence dodgeball right there, ladies and gentlemen. He picked his spot. What a kill. Another ball blocked. Good job by UVA by stopping these balls and understanding the back line. My goodness. Holy smokes. What a throw by number 1. Just misses target, but it's playful nevertheless. Uh-oh. Yikes, they're playing a very dangerous game of chicken right now. That's not a game I want to be playing. I am happily retired from the NCDA. I do not want to be a part of this. Team throw, got it. Down go number 6. Oh, what a kill by Hunter. Oh, but Jake with the catch. My goodness, he cannot throw today for whatever reason, but the captain is still making a statement nevertheless. Whoa, and number 64 stepped way over the line. Way over the line. Hunter comes up to throw. Does not get it. Whoa, high throw, and he's in. Oh, good job by his teammates protecting him because he was dead in the water. Good block. UVA is playing very disciplined right now. This is the best they've ever done against Towson. Towson has exactly five players left. They are on the 10 count. Hunter looking to throw. Here it comes. Wild throw. Jake was able to stop it. We'll definitely try to get more names throughout the day. My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa! He missed! He missed! Hunter missed! What a kill by number 9, now pushing Towson to only 3. Two players left for Towson. They're going for a team throw. Who are they going after? Stressful situation. Good throw. Oh, what a shot! One player left to beat. Team throw. Oh, but he made the catch! But he made the catch! And he made it at the expense of number 6, McCormick. Does now bring it in Bash, the lefty. What a catch. By number 21 of Towson, you love to see it. Oh, what a drop catch! What a drop catch! And he hates to see it, he hates it. Number 9, Robinson, that was a catch that he had, but he could not get it. Bass, low throw is good. It will count as a reset throw. Both teams now have under 6 players left. UVA has 5, Towson has 2. This is only the second point. Towson is up 2-0, but UVA is trying to get their first point. Oh, it's a missed catch! Oh, that's another kill! Four players left. Oh, he could not get him! And just like that, the game is tied 1-1. My goodness. This is the first time that UVA has ever taken a point off of Towson. This is crazy. Mrs. Martin, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. She said, love the enthusiasm from the announcer. We're trying to bring that high energy. I'm only working on 4 hours of sleep. I was doing a semi-pro football game on Saturday. I didn't go to bed till like 2, and then I got up around 6. So, you know, I'm doing my best though. I'm trying. We got Morgan saying, yay, UVA. Listen, this is the best, this is like the best that we ever seen UVA have ever looked in their history. I'm a VCU alum, so I don't really have a dog in this fight. So I'm just gonna be neutral. Like, I'm just gonna be neutral the whole day. Like, I'm gonna try my best to try to learn as many names as possible. We just got the rosters late last night. So my apologies if I butcher any of your favorite players' names. It's not what I'm trying to do. Oh my God! And number 10 has showed him mercy. Back in the days, there would be no mercy. He got lit up, and that's a kill by number 1. And he got that grown man swagger step about himself, like he owns the place. And with throws like that, you definitely do own the place, good sir. Good reset throw by Towson. Good pump fake. Oh my God! And Bass with the grown man catch. Take it out, number 60, Kelly. My goodness, Kelly has been a factor in the last point. One of the reasons why UVA even got the point. He is a baller. My goodness, what a vicious pump fake. That's another, is that a kill? We don't know. We do not know. We're about to find out. Uh-oh. He's looking for it. Let's see which side's going to throw. All right, right side through, no dice. There's only, I think, one player out from UVA, and that's Kelly. There's no plays out for Towson. Both teams are playing extremely well right now. What a throw, though. Eddie will get this ball back. Both teams are playing very disciplined right now. This is Towson's first tournament, the first match of the day. I don't know. I don't know that was a catch or not. The refs are not saying anything. Multiple teams are on the right side does not work, but they will get their ball back nevertheless. Oh, he's by himself. That's a terrible mistake. I understand what he was doing, but you can't do that against Hunter and think you're going to win that battle. You're going to lose. Woo! Teams are on the left side successful. Caught him sleeping. Was able to pick him off. And just like that, there's three UVA players that are down. Towson is still at their full strength at 12. And Strong, being the strong grown man that he is, just taking his time. Another UVA player goes down, this time number 10. Timeout call. And much needed. Let's see if we actually had the clock. I think we actually do now. It is, oh my God. Is that 1:55 left in the first half? Oh my God. Holy smoke. Ladies and gentlemen, 1:55 is left in the first half. This has been a very competitive game. You know, when you're having fun, time just moves by very, very quickly. And I got to say, first of all, shout out to UVA for just coming out here once again. The level of discipline that they have is incredible. Years past, we would say that Towson, UVA, this would be a wash. Towson going to move on to play against JMU. Not today, y'all. Not today. It's a completely different story. But yeah, completely different story today, y'all. Ball in the middle. Towson's easily going to get it. Reset throw for both teams. No dice. No dice, y'all. UVA has exactly three balls. Now it's only two. After three. Both teams are just resetting right now. So this is a very good question that we have from Angel Garrett Tiger. What is the score of the Penn State versus JMU game? So here's the kicker, y'all. We on court one. Court two is like a 5-minute walk from here, give or take. So I'm going to have to figure out what the score is at halftime, because I will literally have to leave my post and pretty much tell y'all what the score is. So we'll try to get that around halftime if possible. Oh, team throw does get them. And UVA got to stay alert because Towson will do that. Woo! Hold up. That is a catch. That is a catch for number 37 Strong. And here it comes. And there goes the Tiger offense just going on full effect. UVA is just not paying attention. They're doing everything right, except just being aware. This is where court vision really plays a huge factor, everybody. The first throw. And it seems like that's going to be a balls over against UVA. Let's see how much time we have left. 42 seconds left in the first half, y'all. Only 42 seconds left. go ahead and turn that crowd mic back up a little bit. But yeah, UVA is doing everything right, except after the first and second throws that come their way, they're not paying attention to the third and fourth. They're getting picked off.
Three, two,
team throw, pump fake. Trying to keep them very disorientated right now. Team throws, does not get them, but they still keep them honest. He jumped, dodged both of them somehow, some way. All right, he did a good job paying attention to that third ball. That's what I'm talking about. There's only one player left. Number six is that knocked out for that chase. Oh, he just missed it! He missed the catch! He could have had it. My goodness. Exactly 10 seconds left. And with that being said, that time will be added on to the second half. Oh, my goodness. Wow. That was a really good attempt by UVA. They just could not figure a way how to. Could not just pull it in the end. You hate to see it. And that being said, in the second half, it's going to be 20 minutes and 10 seconds. And the reason why that we're doing 20 minutes halves instead of 25 minutes half is for the sake of time. And with that being said, we're going to have time. And I'm going to charge up my devices. So we'll be back momentarily. That. I just turned the audio. Good catch though by Towson. Anyway, sorry about that. We should be good now. Good block. Hunter, good block. Long throw, easy catch. Long throw, easy catch. Alright. Oh, got him. 49 goes down. Good overhand throw by UVA, but just doesn't quite work in that particular situation. And the team throw works against number 64, McCormick. McComb. UVA is almost down to a 10-man count, well, to a 10-second shot clock. Not a team throw. Oh! Almost hit his glasses, but he was able to block it. Team throw. Ooh, good block at the last second, preventing that team throw to happen. All right, cool.
Team right,
team throw kind of just misses on that exchange. All right, and we just found out that JMU is up 2-0 against Penn State at the half. So thank you, Hunter Ford, for telling us that. Much appreciated.
Hey, they got that from you.
All right, cool. Penn State is going to be playing 4 games today. So, and they don't get a break, so they're going to be tired. Woo! What a shot, but nevertheless, that was a good catch by number 33. Kind of missed that off of camera. Too much recoil time, and he was able to snag it. And with that, UVA is on a 10 count. My apologies. Now they're on a 10 count. They have exactly 5 players now. Jake, relax. I know life is stressful right now, but I need you to relax, my guy. Then again, I'm not on the court, so I have that luxury of saying that. Block. Oh, God. Oh, man, I almost saw my life flash before my eyes. Oh, sweet baby Jesus.
Left arm.
There is no shot clock right now on the fact that UVA has. Oh, that's a shot. You got a tattoo on that chain. Oh, man. Nothing. Yeah, so Jake is not able to throw his normal throws right now, so he's trying to figure out what he can do in this situation. It's going to be interesting. Ooh, the sidearm throw. Okay. He might be able to do something with that. But if Towson keep on pushing their opponent to the back line and playing the wall ball strategy, there's not really a whole lot that UVA can do right now. Not really. You hate to see it. Team throw, stagger team throw, kind of at the end, or stagger throw, just being honest. No dice. Jake going way up by himself. So I had to pull it back at the last minute. Another team throw, or it should have been a team throw, but didn't quite happen. Anywho. Nice. Well, well, cop. Woo! Man, Jake was trying, man. He was trying. I'll give him that. Well, Kyle, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, you know, I hate the wall ball strategy too, but when you got it, you can use it, man. Plus, this is their court. It is what it is. Yeah, so in regarding to the Penn State JMU game, here's the kicker. Towson has a very, very strict spectator restriction, as in, if you're not playing or you're not live streaming like I'm doing, you do not have the right to be here. So that means that the people that we would have had for live streaming just got cut down by like 95%. So we can't stream court two. We just can't. Out of my control. It's not really much I can do.
Oh my God! Jesus!
Jesus! That's gonna leave a mark. God, and that was in, man, and we got that in 4K too? God bless. The editing process. Woo! My God! Yeah, I don't know, man. It is what it is. Team throw, got him. Yeah, so when I was talking to Drew, captain of JMU, earlier this morning, he was saying, like, yes, that is a catch. He fell out of bounds, but that is still a catch nevertheless. He's out, but that was a hell of a catch nevertheless. But yeah, when I was talking to Drew this morning, he was telling me, like, yesterday, JMU was supposed to have at least about 25 spectators and our full team. I was like, that's what's up, man. That's what's up. But when Towson said, like, yeah, spectators, don't even bother showing up. I was like, man. So that's the reason why we can't get court two streaming. So it is what it is. But you will see Towson versus JMU on this court, though, which will be coming up next. And that's going to be a fun one. Towson's up 3-1. Let's actually pull, let me actually pull up the schedule real quick. We do have some cool comments on YouTube. Go Dukes. Go Balls Deep. Love to see it. Yep. Love to see it. Definitely love to see it. I will say, though, JMU definitely do have some of the best fans in the country. That's not even an East Coast bias. That's just keeping it 100. They love to travel. I will say that. They love to travel. I'm not even saying anything about that. I can't repeat what they said. Anywho. Let's see how much time we have left. 9:33 left in the game. Towson is up comfortably 3-1. But yeah, on this court, it's going to be Towson versus UVA, and then Penn State versus Maryland is going to be on court two. Anywho, is that a kill. It is a kill against Towson. All right, good job. Woo! Got. Team catch. You took a shot, but that's a kill. That's a kill. Two Tigers goes down. UVA still got the full 12 on the court.
Up, up, up! 17, 17!
Unfortunately, there is no Discord to watch AMU today. We don't have the personnel, nor the staff, nor the resources to provide you two live streams. If we had more volunteers, I could have easily had that set enough, but it is what it is. What a kill, though. Take it out, number one, White the fifth. The fifth, huh? Okay, that's what's up. 2-12 for UVA does not work. Woo! Somehow number 34 survived that exchange. I have no idea how he did, but he is grateful nonetheless. Blocked by Towson. Good reset throw by Towson. Cali coming up. He throws. Good throw. Good throw. Taking their time now. Oh, that's not going to count. And that's a kill. Good job by number 37 Strong with the kill. Catch and take it out, number 37 Strong of that exchange. But yeah. Woo! But yeah, Towson is very strict when it comes to how many people can actually show up to an event, so it's outside my control. It is what it is. All right, here comes Hunter. The throw does not get it. Does not get it. Low throw does not get it. With the good hit right there. UVA is doing a good job chipping off these players. By number 33 Bass is right there. And it seems like Towson have kind of settled down a little bit now.
Hey,
good block. Oh, got him with the kill. Team throw on the left side does not work. Yikes. Oh, well. 41 goes down for UVA. Ready. There we go. Woo! He missed that one. Dodged both of them somehow. I have no idea how he did that. Wes Peters, all right, we just came in with a new announcement, y'all. This is breaking news. Wes Peters had just changed his prediction with JMU versus Towson. And you heard it here, folks. He said 5-1 in favor of JMU. So you heard it here first, y'all. He just changed his prediction. Midstream, y'all. Midstream. All right. I'm about to say, I don't have access to Twitter, but we can act like Twitter right now, bring you the breaking news wherever we can. Speaking of which, I need to change my fantasy football update. I need to do that. I can't be losing three straight games. That ain't gonna work. Anywho, back to business. This game has kind of just been stalling with both teams just doing reset throws. Towson is up comfortably 3-1, trying to figure out how much time is left. 1:35 left. So this game is pretty much over. This game is pretty much over. But let's see if we can get some good headshots in. Or catches, either or. But, you know, it's interesting. That's actually a good point. Club sports should be able to live stream at least one of the courts and not all of the games for their respective schools, especially if they can't have spectators. That's actually a pretty good point. The real question is, are they willing to pay somebody to do that type of work? That's the real question. Because it's one thing to ask for it, it's another thing to do it, and to do it well. Not everybody can do that. But that's a good question, though. It's a good question. Missed catch, taking down number 10. Long throw does not work in that exchange. Woo! Another good kill. And that's pretty much the game. And with that, Towson wins 3-1. Alrighty. First game of the day, Towson wins 3-1. Ready. Next game is about to be Towson versus JMU. Let's see if we can figure out what the score is on the other court real quick. We don't know, so we're still waiting. And with that being said, if you are joining the stream thus far and you actually want to support the NCDA, to where they actually have more people to actually do live streaming multiple courts at the same time. You do know that the NCDA does have a PayPal account, y'all. That's right. Whoops. That is football. My apologies. There you go. The PayPal account right there. So at NCDA Dodgeball, you can actually go to our website at www.ncdadodgeball.com. The NCDA is a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so your donations will be tax deductible. So if you're trying to lower your taxes and trying to get more of your money back come February time to come to file those taxes, you can do that. So the NCDA, they have three different funds. They have the scholarship funds, the officiating funds, and the recruitment and retention fund. The scholarship fund is actually us creating scholarships for students, so that way they have the opportunity to utilize their skill sets in the business and organization setting. We had some people actually do live streaming through the internship, as well as other administrative stuff in regards to that. And it's actually been quite helpful. They also do some video editing as well, as well as also updating the rule books and whatnot. So a lot of cool stuff. So the officiating fund, this will actually be geared towards paying the refs. So we can actually, you know, have referee shirts, whistles, penny shirts. Everyone out here who is a ref is either a college student or they're volunteering because they're an alumni. So anytime we can have more refs, the game is less biased and we actually have better quality on the court. And last but not least, the retention, the recruitment and retention fund. So COVID-19 has been pretty brutal for a lot of universities, you know, across the United States. There are some universities, they're on the verge of just not existing anymore. And when you donate money, you know, towards this particular fund, this will help us in terms of recruiting teams and retaining them. And it will also help out our lead ambassador program. And so what this does, this allows people like myself and others, folks on the e-board, as well as the content team, to actually travel to local teams and actually help out at practices, as well as attending involvement fairs to recruit new teams. Also, this money right here also helps out with, you know, traveling costs for live streaming as well. So yeah. And with that being said, we should be seeing JMU momentarily. And we'll ask them what the score is. And we will go from there.
Girl, don't be complacent. You better take that.